So please give a big, big recognition to our new Sapphire manager, Bernie Allen.
Is it true what Amanda said, that we hear her before we see her? Yeah?
Yes.
Well, Bernie, what can I say?
I don't know.
She's made us smile the last week or two because she said that I think it's in Africa or somewhere they can't pronounce Sapphire manager, so she's the first ever Safari manager. So. Yeah, I don't think in all my years I've ever recognised a Safari manager before, so that's a first for me. But I tell you something about Bernie, and that is, whenever I travel around the world, when Bernie's not with me, people always say, "How's Bernie doing?" And I can promise you that one of the first people that Rex ever asks about when I'm with him is, "How's that Bernie Allen doing?" So she's so loud, they've even heard her right across in Arizona. Now, you don't get noticed that way if you haven't helped and contributed lots and lots along the way. And that's what Bernie does day in, day out. And for, well, almost since time began here in Forever Ireland, she's inspired people to see the vision of Forever. It's been challenging at times for her, but she's kept going and she's always kept the vision. As a result of that, many, many people in Ireland have captured the vision of what Forever can do for them as a result of Bernie Allen. So from not just myself and the team at Macromorne, Bernie, but everybody on the board in the US, Rex, Aidan, Greg, all send their congratulations to you. We're really, really proud of your achievements, and it's great to see you here today as Sapphire manager. Many congratulations.
Oh my God, I am so happy. You have no idea what it feels like. I have been happy for the last 2 weeks. Nobody can annoy me. And then I thought I was as happy as it ever could be, and my best two friends in the world just walked through the door just about 15 minutes ago. Oh. Anyway, thank you very much. And I really would like to thank everybody who said to me, congratulations. But I listened to the words that you tagged on to the end, and you said, well done, you deserve it. And that was lovely to hear from people. And there was two people who asked me, would I come and do a wee bit of training for them in January, and they put a wee promotion on. And they said, you know, even people that's not doing 4 cc's is doing 8 cc's to come and hear you speak. Do you know how well that does your heart, like, that you're helping other people? And, well, yous all know what these ones are like. You know. So really, for anybody that's here for the very first time, God bless yous. You know, when you look at this and you go, they're mad. You know, if you had our bank account, you'd be mad too. Do you know? That's the truth. You know, like Julie Mackey's over there. Do you remember, Julie, I used to do my last 6 transactions 5 times a day? Is that the truth? I used to go to the doo-doot in the hole in the wall and check my account 6 times a day to check was there enough money in it to pay my bills. And now sometimes I forget to put my checks in. That's the truth. So if you're here for the first time, it's amazing. And I just want to share with you a little bit of information. Amanda, isn't Amanda beautiful standing up here? Well, and you're doing a wonderful job, Amanda. I taught you well, pet. So, Pauline's going to kill me. Pauline's going to kill me now for that one. Pauline will kill me for that one. It doesn't matter. I'm used to Pauline killing me. So what you got to do, folks, you know, people ask for, whenever you see a leader or whatever, you say, give us a wee bit of advice. Is that right? Give us a wee bit of advice. Well, last year, I've always wanted to be Sapphire. For 13 years, I've wanted to be Sapphire. And, you know, nobody ever sat down and said to me, what do you want? Do you know? And be careful with your people. Make sure you know what they want. And don't be putting it into their heads what you think they want. It's what they want is very important. So I took a picture. And I had this sash. Isn't that gorgeous? And I took a picture. And I got a mock done with this sapphire sash on. And I cut it out. And I made it my bookmarker for every single day of the year. So every day that I turned the page, this was in my bookmarker every single day. Yeah? So I could not be Sapphire. Is that the truth? My second goal was to lose 2 stone and to buy a Sapphire. And to buy a Sapphire dress to be on the stage. So I thought, I got to do that as well. So I achieved that as well. So it's not to impress you, but to impress upon you, when you put your head to anything, you can do it. You really can do it. And you don't get to Sapphire without people along the way. And people will say, tell me that I'm lucky. Believe me, the many no's that I've had, and all the leaders in this room will know. Lisa's not right. Where's Lisa Walsh? Lisa, sure, I wouldn't be here without you, Penn. That's right. Lisa said to me, when you get on the stage, tell them I taught you everything. So you have to go out and get your nose to get your managers. And whenever I got my managers, like, if you have a look at here, ladies and gentlemen, let's see what we have. That was my first managers, Patrick and Claire Hughes. And Patrick and Claire came to my house. It's to show you the different types of people that does be in your business. And when Patrick and Claire came to my house, he used to do photocopying for Forever Living products. And Forever Living, I had a photocopying machine, and I asked them, could you send somebody to me to help me? And they sent Patrick. And I said to him, you've been down at head office and you're not in our business. Why is that? He says, nobody told me about it. Now remember, this is 20 years ago. Yeah, we didn't even know what we were doing 20 years ago. So Patrick came to my house, and then he told me I was lucky. He says, you'll be able to build this business because you're lucky, because you've got arthritis in the spine. That's a true story. He says, there's nothing wrong with us. So you're lucky because you're not well. Yep, that's what he told me. And Patrick and Claire's goal was to travel, get married, and have a cruise around the world for their honeymoon. And that was my very, very, very first manager. And then we have my next manager was Mary Kearney. Where's Mary? God bless Mary. Mary came to my house for a party. It was my birthday. She didn't know she was coming to a business meeting. That's the truth. And she brought a wee plant and all with her. And she says, what's going on? I says, Mary, just get in. Come on, have a wee bit of crack and I'll tell you about it later. And she signed in after the party. Isn't that the truth, Mary? Yeah. She came to a party. That's how Mary came into the business. Now, let me go back there. Mary's background is in Marks and Spencer's. So Patrick was a photocopying, and Mary was in Marks and Spencer's. And Mary worked 7 days a week. Believe me, and she looked after her mommy. Isn't that right, Mary? Yeah. And Mary had no time. Do you ever hear people telling you they've got no time? Mary had no time. And Mary was one of my fastest managers in the business. So everybody's different. And then we have Donna Gill. This is a very interesting story, because the meetings that I had in the Ivanhoe in Belfast, Donna was the receptionist. And every night that I walked out, I used to go, because nobody ever tips the receptionist. You always tip the waiter and all. And Donna was always lovely. And I would have slipped a wee something under the counter for her. And one day I said to her, why, Donna, why don't you do this business? And she said, I was in network marketing before, and I got tortured so much, I would never look at it again. And I says, well, if you ever crash a car, Donna, and you never get back behind the wheel, you'll never drive again. Oh, no, I'm not interested. And the very next day I got a call, and I thought I got a call because I forgot to pay the bill. And she says, no, I'd just like to meet you. So we met her, and Donna was in very much debt. She had 11 Visa cards, and 3 of them her husband didn't know anything about. She was scared stiff. So we paid all them off. And at the end of that, Donna told me that the money that I put under the counter got her a loaf, a pint of milk, and the bus fare for her children to go to school. And she used to wait on me coming through the door, and one night I forgot, and she had to walk the children to school. So you don't know who you're talking to, and you don't know what you're doing to people's lives. And then we have Simon Shields. Now, Simon used to own his own newspaper company, and he came one day to sell me advertising. Huge mistake. And he said that he didn't have time to build the business because the newspaper was killing him. And I says, tell you what to do, you send all the people to me and I'll look after them. And then by the time you have a business, I'll come back and let you know. Yeah, and Simon became manager in the business. And then we'll have Attractor Higgins, who just shocked the life out of me and walked through the door. Attractor and Vincey, this is an unbelievable story. I was down in Sligo doing a business opportunity meeting, and afterwards I went into the bar, as you do. And there was a dance on, and this guy came up to the counter, or the bar, and said to me, would you like to dance? Now, when I tell you he was a village idiot, I don't exaggerate. And a tractor who doesn't know me came up and said to me, we felt so sorry for you. I'm awful sorry. Come on over to our table. And I went over to their table, and I told her about, she asked me what I did, and I says, if I told you what I did, you'd think I was drunk. And she said, what? If I told you what I earned, you'd think I was drunk, and I've only had one drink. I says, give me your number and I'll call you tomorrow. And that's how I met Attractor. Yeah. So be very careful what you say to people, because they can't believe what the business can offer you. And then we'll have Lorraine. And Lorraine is a podiatrist. And Lorraine got so much wonderful results with the products that she came into the business through the heat lotion. She got so much results with them. Can you notice the difference? And we'll have Karina. And Karina was a makeup artist. And she wanted to join Forever, and she came into Forever. But Karina has been in so many network marketing companies, she'll never, ever, ever settle herself. But she became a manager in my business, and you want to see the people she's brought into my business. So also remember that. It's maybe not the person that you bring in, but it's the persons that they know that'll build your business. And then we have Anne-Melia. And Anne and I met at an angel day, an angel therapy day. And I was the guest speaker. And afterwards, Anne was talking about angels, angels, angels. And I was going, oh boy, do I want you in my business. But she thought it was an angel business. And when Anne came into my life, Anne works, she's very, very high up in Galway University. And I thought, this woman's too posh for me. Do you see when I know her now? I'm not even going to tell you anything. So from these managers, ladies and gentlemen, led to an opportunity. that I now have what's called the Team Achievers Managers Club, which is wonderful to sit round the table every single month. And instead of me making all the decisions, I've got my managers. And where's the Team Achievers Managers Club? Put up your hands. I'm very, very proud of yous all, and yous know how proud I am of you. And from the Team Achievers came all the managers and all the downline from Sligo, from Donegal, from Mayo, from Dublin, from all parts of Northern Ireland. Where have I left out? I know. And from Cork. And that's where all this led from one or two or three people. That's all that happens. So don't sit there and think I don't know anybody. Every single person on that screen I didn't know. And last but not least, we have my little torture. And when I tell you she's my wee torture, I mean she's my wee torture. You've heard her talking here today. Well, when Shell rings you up, that's all you hear. Yeah? And she didn't say something today, and she's really disappointed, so I'm going to give her an opportunity to say what she wanted to say.
I only qualified for manager because Bernie told me if it didn't, she would beat me with a big stick.
She said, for those people who need interpretation for Shell, she said that Bernie only qualified for manager because Bernie said if I didn't, I'd get beat with a big stick. And this is a very interesting story, ladies and gentlemen. I met Shell when she was 7 years of age. Her mommy was my customer. And they loved the products so much that Shell grew up with the products. And last December, I was at a Christmas fair, and Shell came over and said to me, Bernie, do you not remember me? And I thought, oh my God, that's a woman standing in front of me. And she joined the business, and today she's a manager in my business at 7 years of age. So ladies and gentlemen, I will leave this thought with you. Go out and find all the 7 and 8 year olds because they're going to be your future managers. Thank you very much.
Is that all right?
Let's hear it for Bernie Allen, our brand new Sapphire manager.